Hello students, today we have English lecture and today we'll do new lesson number 3.5, Unbeatable Super Mom Marie Kondo. It's on page 128 in your textbook. Now students, you are familiar with the world famous super mom. You might be heard this Marie Kondo. So today we are going to study about Marie Kondo. Now first, a brief introduction of Marie Kondo. Marie Kondo is an Indian boxer. Kondo was born in Kangithai village in Chirachandrapur district of Manipur in eastern India. So she was born in the place called Manipur in eastern India. Since childhood, Kondo liked athletics, boxing, and was good at age. So she was good in all this sports like athletics and boxing. She became eager and interested in boxing after watching Dinko Singh. She started her career in 2000. The author presents the life and achievement of Marie Kondo in the form of an interview by sports Kera correspondent Taruka Srivastava. Okay, so she was a correspondent, a person who took her interview. That is Taruka Srivastava. Kondo has won the World Boxing Championship 5 times in a row in all 6 world championships. In the 2012 Olympics, she became the first Indian woman boxer to win a bronze medal for India. She is an inspiration to many Indian women. So she is a source of inspiration to many of the Indian women. Now, okay, I have done with the introduction part. Now come here. There had to be one successful story if Indians were to survive in sports, and we have that story now. So we are going to see the story in this lesson, the story about Marie Kondo. Enough has been said about this great warrior who conquered the world. This warrior is none other than Marie Magdie Kondo, okay, the Kondo conqueror and comrade. She is famed as a 5 times world boxing champion. So she has been a world boxing champion for 5 times, and the only boxer to win a medal in every one of 6 world championships. In the year 2012 Olympics, she became the first Indian woman boxer to qualify and win a bronze medal in the 51 kg flyweight category of boxing. So they have got a rule. A basic rule is that a boxer have to be at the weight of 51 kg, and she took part in Olympics game during the year 2012, and she was declared a winner and she has had won a bronze medal. Kondo was born in Kangithai village, Morigong, Lakmaka in Chirachandrapur district of rural Manipur in eastern India. She came from a poor family, so she was belonging to a very poor family. Her parents, Magdie Tonpa Kondo and Magdie Kham Kondo, were tenant farmers. So her parents were farmers who worked in jhum field. So they used to work in the jhum field. Now jhum is what? Farming. That is called shifting cultivation fields. Kondo grew up in a humble surrounding. Humble means what? A simple or in a poor condition surrounding. Helping her parents with farm related chores. Chores means for doing day-to-day work. So she used to help her parents in the farm activities. Going to school and learning athletics initially. So in the beginning, she was learning athletics, like running, you can say running races or something that's called athletics, and later boxing simultaneously. Her father was a mean wrestler in the younger age. So when her father was young, even he too was a wrestler. She had an eager interest in athletics since childhood. So Mary Kom was having an interest in athletics from the time she was a child. And the success of Dinko Singh, a fellow Manipur, returned from 1998 Bangkok Asian Games. So Dinko Singh, who a fellow of Manipur, so even he was from Manipur, and he returned in the year 1998 from Bangkok Asian Games with a gold medal. Kom recollects had inspired many youngsters in Manipur to try boxing, and she too thought of giving it a try. So Kom took interest in boxing, and she decided, even I'll take interest in this particular sport. Mary Kom's career started in 2000 after her victory in Manipur State Women's Boxing Championship and Regional Championship in West Bengal. In 2001, she started competing international level. She was only 18 years old when she made her international debut. Debut means what? First public appearance or performance. So debut is called first public appearance. At the first IBA Women's World Boxing Championship in United States, winning a silver medal in the 48 kg weight category. Her greatness is reinforced. Reinforced means what? Strengthened. By the way, she apologized to the whole nation for not being able to win the gold. So she was not able to win the gold. So she said, "My people of India, I am very sorry that I am not able to win a medal for you." And that was a medal of gold. She is a legend. Legend means one who makes history. For sure, an idol for the sportswoman to look up to. Now, this is an interview. Okay, an interview is taken of Mary Kom. In an exclusive interview with Sports Kira correspondent. So, in newspaper, we have got a column of sports. And then the interview was taken by Taruka Srivastava. Olympic bronze medalist Mary Kom talked about her preparation for the Olympics and elation. Elation means great joy at winning a medal. So it's very natural when anyone wins a medal, you are happy, you are in great joy. Now let us see interview now. Now interviewer. Interview means who's going to take an interview of Mary Kom. First, you are the first Indian female boxer to win an Olympic medal for India. Has the feeling completely sunk in? Sunk in means realized. Have you been realized? Mary Kom replied, "I am really happy with my achievement. And yes, it is yet to sink in. I am just so exhilarated." Exhilarated means very thrilled, or you can say very happy. Next question. Interviewer. You were the only female representative from India in boxing. Did that put additional pressure on you? So the interviewer asked, so you were the only female representative. Did you had any pressure on you? Mary Kom replied, "No, not at all. I was pretty confident about myself, I know." So Mary Kom was very confident. Interviewer. Your coach, you know who's a coach? Who trains you or who teaches you? Charles Atkinson was not allowed to accompany you to Olympics. How did that affect your preparations? Mary Kom says, "Well, I did miss him there. So his coach was not there with him, so she missed him. But thankfully, we had already done our homework and I was well prepared. During your preparations for the Olympics, you sped with the male boxers of the Indian contingent. Who was your favorite sparring partner? Sparring means motions of boxing during training without landing on actual blows. Okay, so this is just a practice they have. Mary Kom laughs. Well, I trained hard in Pune and the male boxers were kind enough to practice with me whenever I required them. So she was the only female over there and she was staying with the male boxers, but they also supported her. I required them to name a favorite would be unfair. So I would not like to name, if she would name only few persons, then it was not an unfair. Next question. Interviewer says, you were quoted saying Adams was very clever, a counterpuncher, but although she carried power, she wasn't very tactile. Tactical means plan, action to gain victory. I was scoring, but the judges were not pressing the buttons. Do you think dodging means what? Unjust. Sometimes the judges also do unjust judging. Was part of the reason for your loss in the semi-finals? Mary Kom, yes, I think some of the decisions were unfortunate and did not work to my benefit. So some of the decisions taken by the judges were not correct. Interviewer says, India managed just 6 medals in 2012 Olympics. Even though we are a nation of 1.3 billion people, where do you think a change is required to help us win medals that are proportionate with our population? So here, Mary Kom replies, I think more and more people should take up sports as a full-time career. So Mary Kom said that more people should involve in sports and they should make sports as their career. If we want more gold medals, more corporators means what? Companies or industries who will sponsor this players or the sportsmen when they're taking part for international sports. Come in and sponsor. You know what you mean by sponsor? Organization that pays or aids sportsmen or a sport event. Players, so that the players don't have any financial pressure and can just focus on their games. So Mary Kom was of the opinion that some of the corporates or some of the sponsors should sponsor those people who are interested in the event of sports. Next question. Interviewer says, do you think interest in boxing in India will ever go beyond the Olympics? Mary Kom replies, yes, I am sure that in a few years, boxing will be very popular among everyone in India all the year round. And she said, boxing is going to be one of the important a popular game in India. Interviewer questions, how aware are Indian women of their nutritional requirement? You know what you mean by nutritional, what food we eat. Diet and nutrition must have been a key factor in your conditioning. Conditioning means like becoming fit for the Olympics. Do you think nutrition is neglected area in Indian sports? Mary Kom replies, the awareness is growing now among the female athletes. When it comes to nutritional requirements, nutrition has definitely been neglected area in Indian sports. See, what is important? Your nutrition. Your nutrition have to be good. Then only you'll be able to achieve in your sports. I had to gain 3 kg since I had to fight in the 51 kg event instead of the usual 48 cages that I fight in. So I had to focus on what to eat. I gained weight by eating the right kind of healthy food rather than bad saturated fat. Saturated fat means what? Unhealthy, unhealthy fat. Introduces, how big a role did OGQ play in shaping the boxing scene in India for the better? Now, OGQ means what? Olympic gold prize. Mary Kom replies, OGQ really played an important part in my success. They helped me out whenever I needed something. They took care of everything, which helped me focus on my boxing and kept me stress-free. Next question. Interviewer says, what's your opinion on the future of Indian boxing? Mary Kom replies, the future is very bright, and I am sure many more boxers will get medals for us. Interviewer, do you find it difficult to convince your children not to fight when they watch you go out and do it in a style all the time? Mary Kom, here she replies, well, I have twins. You know what you mean by twins. Okay, so she has twins, and yes, sometimes it becomes really difficult to keep them under control. Interviewer says, well, you train your kids to become boxers as well? Mary Kom says, I haven't really thought about it as of now. Just let the mother box. So here Mary Kom replies, I have not decided about my children. At present, let the mother only keep on boxing. Interviewer says, you have broken several stereotypes. Stereotype means what? A fixed idea held as a common standard about the woman in India by showing that women can compete with men in any field. But how good are you at the traditional feminine activities like cooking? So your traditional feminine means what? Women are thought to be only doing cooking work in the kitchen. But yeah, Mary Kom has proved that women can do different thing also. Mary Kom replies, well, I'm good at cooking and other household work too. Interviewer, would you be interested in coaching Indian women in boxing one day? Mary Kom replies, let's see, in the future, maybe yes. So she wants to train other women also in Indian women in the field of boxing. Interviewer, what do you prefer, being called super mom or super boxer? Mary Kom, I love being a mom. That's the best thing that has ever happened to me. So she says that I want to be simple like a mom and nothing else. Hope so, students, you have understood the lesson. Now, please do question number one, choose the correct alternative and underline it, do it. Next thing, go to the text again and find out the name on cities. Okay, do it. Question number three, go to the text again and complete the following sentences. Do it. Question four, you will find some acronyms, that is short forms, in the text. Okay, try to find the answers for this. Question number five, fill in the blanks of Mary Kom. Don't do it, it's omitted. Question number six, please do it. Question number seven, omit. Question number eight, omit. Question number nine, omit. Question number 10 is omitted. Question number 11, make sentences. Please do it. Question number 12, please do it. Question number 13, underline the subordinate clause. Do it. Question number 14, please do it. Pick out the verbs, noun, and adjectives. Do it. Now here, 15, 16, 17, and 18 has been omitted. So, students, please do it. Thank you very much.